I think maybe we can try to help fail truth is concrete a little bit. I think maybe we should try to let it fail. So I propose a sort of like a performance experiment where what's going to happen is you see I have these things in front of me and I'm wearing this sheet. We've got scissors, I have makeup, and a pen. I'm going to start reading the, I'm just going to stand here, and start reading the truth is concrete description. And I would like to invite anybody, preferably everybody, to come up one at a time, or two at a time, or three at a time, and interact with me using these objects in one way or another. Please don't, like, cut me. But please do cut the sheet. I will not stop reading it. Well, I may. But probably not. And I'm going to take off my glasses. But don't poke me in the eye. In fact, maybe conservatively around this. Is everybody comfortable with that? Sounds good. You'll start. Give me a couple sentences to start.
Okay.
Truth is concrete. These have been months, years of unbelievably fast change all over the world. Uprisings in the Arabic world. Revolutions and counter-revolutionary attempts. Islamistic threats and the fetishization of Islamistic threats. Demonstrations and repercussions in Russia, Ukraine, Belarusia. Persecutions of artists, sometimes under a bright spotlight, as in the cases of Pussy Riot or Ai Weiwei, but more often unnoticed by a broader public. The nuclear disaster in Japan. The appearance and disappearance of Occupy all over the world. The rise of the right wing in many countries, often as a side effect of the financial devastations that threatened the whole European project. The fundamental destruction of social, educational, and cultural structures. Where to start? Where to end? On our travels during the last 1.5 years, be it to Zuccotti or Tahrir Square, to Japan after Fukushima, or to Moscow during a wave of demonstrations, to London, Budapest, Athens, Istanbul, Ramallah, Tel Aviv, Tunis, Rio, or Buenos Aires, everywhere artists were among the first to get involved, among the first to join the political and social movements. But how did art, how did artistic strategies and tactics play a role? At a time when art, theory, and practice seem to be constantly lagging behind reality, when art is seen more and more as a mere leftist hobby rather than a foundation of humanity, we have learned that there are no easy answers anymore. We don't trust ideologies, even though we follow the ideology of capitalism. We know everything is contingent and relative. We replace critique with criticality, the political with the post-political, the neoliberal capitalism with cultural capitalism. But where the answers get too complicated, the desire for simple solutions is growing. And we, perhaps indeed leftist hobbyists, seem to have lost contact with the larger base. The constant awareness of the complexity of the notions of truth, reality, or even politics seem to have maneuvered us into a dead-end road. Whether we are too simple or we are too complex, too populist or too stuck in a hermetic arithmetism. Either we include too much or we exclude too many. The common ground of art and activism. So what is to be done? Can art help solve problems that politics and society themselves have ignored for so long? Should art be a social or political tool? Can it be useful? And why should artists know what to do when nobody else does? Truth is concrete, is what was written in big letters over Bertolt Brecht's desk in his Danish exile, quoting Lenin, quoting Hegel, quoting Augustine. And in another corner there was, as Walter Benjamin writes in his notes, a little wooden donkey standing with a sign around his neck, even I must understand. We take the possibility of concrete truth as a working hypothesis and look for direct action, for concrete change in knowledge, for an art that not only represents and documents, but that engages in specific political and social situations, and for an activism that not only acts for the sake of acting, but searches for intelligent, creative means of self-empowerment, artistic strategies and tactics in politics, political strategies and tactics in art. Art and politics always have been in strange love-hate relationships. Truth is concrete purposely ignores many of the borders, conflicts, and resentments. Art is not activism, and activism is not art. But the common ground, the shared space, is large and important. It offers a chance for art to be engaged, connected, and relevant, and it offers activism a chance not to get stuck in ideology, routine, and functionalism, a chance to stay unpredictable and sharp. The Truth is Concrete takes a close look at what happens where the differences between art and activism are important. Marathon Camp. For 170 hours, more than 200 perform, play, produce, discuss, and collect useful ics. A full grant program additionally invited 100 om all over the world. The marathon is a platform, a apement. It is a machine that runs non-stop. Often... Truth is concrete. Years of unbelievably fast change all over the world. Uprisings in the Arabic world, revolutions and counter-revolutionary attempts, Islamistic threats and the fetishization of Islamistic threats. Demonstrations and repercussions in Russia, Ukraine, Belarus, persecution of artists, sometimes under a bright spotlight, as in the cases of Pussy Riot or Ai Weiwei, but more often unnoticed by a broader public, the nuclear disaster in Japan, the appearance and disappearance of Occupy all over the world, the rise of the right wing in many countries. On our travel during the last 1.5 years, be it to Zuccotti or Tahrir Square, to Japan after, or to Moscow during the wave of demonstrations, to London, Budapest, Athens, Istanbul, Ramallah, Tel Aviv, Tunis, Rio, or Buenos Aires, everywhere artists were among the first to get involved, among the first to join the political and social. But how did art, how did artistic strategies end play a role? At a time when art, theory, and practice seem to be constantly lagging behind reality, when art is seen more and more as a leftist rather than a of humanity.